Okay, what is the difference between ungrouped and grouped data? Okay, so for ungrouped data, it is raw data, not in the form of interval and frequency distribution that has been arranged in order. While for grouped data, the data that is grouped into class interval summarized in a frequency distribution table. Okay. The example for ungrouped data, given that one problem, okay, after a survey, the number of male children in 18 families chosen at random is as follows. Okay, this one is raw data for the number of male children. Okay, so the above data is called raw data. Okay, the data can be summarized neatly as a frequency distribution as shown below. So this one is frequency distribution. Okay, so number of male children, okay, 0 1 2 3 4 5, and then the frequency for 0 male children is 2, frequency for 1 male children 4, and so on. Okay, based on the raw data, and then you convert it to frequency distribution. And then this one is an example for group data. Okay, given that one problem, the length of 24 leaf collected from a garden is measured to the nearest centimeter, and the following results obtained. Okay, so this one is the raw data. Okay, raw data for 24 leaf, okay, collected from a garden. Okay, and then convert the raw data to frequency distribution. Okay, the frequency distribution below shows the same data but grouped in the following intervals. Okay, so a frequency distribution table, length of the leaf in interval from 9 to 10 cm, the frequency is 2 leaf. Okay, and then from 11 to 12 cm, frequency is 6. Until 19 to 20 cm, the frequency is 1. Okay, so this data in the form of frequency distribution is known as group data. So this one what we call group data. Okay, we can group the data in different intervals, but there are steps on how to construct a frequency distribution table. I will show how to construct a frequency distribution table in next slide. The terminology we use in frequency distributions: number one, class frequency, the number of individuals belonging to each class, and then frequency distribution table, tabular arrangement of data by classes with data frequencies, and then lower class limits, the lowest values of various classes, and then upper class limits, the highest values of various classes. Okay, next, class boundaries obtained by adding the upper limit of one class interval to the lower limit of the next higher class interval and dividing it by 2. Actually, you find the average. Okay, and then class width or class size, okay, or C. Okay, the difference between the upper and lower boundaries of any class. Class mark, midpoint, midpoint of class interval obtained by calculating the mean of the lower and upper class limit. Given that example 1, data below shows the raw data for blood pressures of 30 patients in hospital B. Okay, A, by selecting class intervals of 90 to 99, 100 to 109, and so on, construct the frequency distribution table for the blood pressures of 30 patients in hospital B. Alright, so given that the class interval start from 90 to 99, followed by 100 to 109, And then the third interval here start from 110 to 119, and the last interval 120 to 129. Okay, so because our highest blood pressure here is 129. Okay, so the interval stop until 129. If let's say we have data that greater than 129, for example 135, okay, so you just add on extra interval, okay, 130 to 139, okay, and then okay, this part is a lower class limit, the lowest values of various classes, and this part is for upper class limits, the highest values of various classes. Okay, so when the lower and the upper class limit is included, then it is an inclusive class interval. So this one is inclusive class interval. Next question, example 1b, by selecting class intervals of 90 to 100, 100 to 110, and so on, construct the frequency distribution table for the blood pressures of 30 patients in hospital B. The interval will start from 90 to 100, 100 to 110, based on the question, and then followed by 110 to 120, and the last interval will be 120 to 130. Okay, so when the lower limit is included, okay, but the upper limit is excluded, and then it is an exclusive class interval. Okay, for example, in the class interval 90 to 100, the value 90 is included, but 100 is excluded. Okay, for example, in the class interval 110 to 120 here, okay, the value of 120 is not included, but 110 included. Okay, so 120 is included in the interval 120 and 130 only. Okay, so use tally to count. Make sure that you put the patient in the right interval. Okay, the exclusive class intervals are usually used in continuous variable cases. So part A here is inclusive class interval, and part B here is exclusive class interval.